Imagine yourself in a room with a pearly white wall, smooth and white ceiling, and a glassy floor. Everything is beautiful and shiny. And then suddenly, you notice a pebble-sized black dot at the center of the wall. And boom! All of your attention is grabbed by this dot just because it did not fit into the perfect room. I am Namita Sharma and I'm going to change the way you look at yourself. Imperfections. We all have them, right? Nobody is perfect. This line is so cliche. But why is this cliche? Because it is the truth. One of my major imperfections is that I am an introvert. Socializing with people is my biggest nightmare. And sitting in a history lecture seemed way more interesting than gossiping with a group of girls. Since I was an introvert, people started criticizing me like this. Oh, this girl is so discreet. She never speaks to me. Or she has so much of attitude. And after all this drama and criticism, I finally decided that, okay, I'll start socializing with people and I started forcing myself to communicate with people. But it was a real disaster. Like a few months ago, I decided meeting one of my old friends and I opened the door and we started off the conversation by saying hi. And then she came closer. That time I was really confused because I had the hardest decision to make at that time, which was whether I should hug her or shake her hand. And being socially awkward, I decided to try both. And I failed miserably at it. And then I tried my best to conversate with her and I failed at it too. And then I realized that I was being completely fake. Whatever I did was just a cover for my imperfection. Don't we all do this? Always finding up a way to cover up for our imperfection. But why? Why to cover it up when you can just accept it? Until and unless you don't accept yourself, you can never, never expect others to accept you. Learning to accept yourself is more important than making others accept you. Because it's how you see yourself that actually matters. So stop. Stop rejecting yourself. Embrace yourself, love yourself, and accept yourself. Don't be afraid to be different from everyone else. Be afraid to be same as everyone else because your imperfections makes you look different from everyone else. To conclude, I would like to recite a beautiful poem by Judy Garland, which goes like this. I am unspeakably loud, insanely normal, creatively dull, horribly good, simply complex, patiently anxious, cowardly courageous, arrogantly humble, hysterically calm, and perfectly imperfect. Or so I'm told. And I am completely okay with it. Thank you.